We went from an idea, a CAD drawing, all the way up to building a physical bioreactor in a matter of months.
The lab space here really is a scientist's playground.
We scaled by a factor of 1,000x since we've been at HAX.
Thinking back to when we arrived, like, the level of technical and commercial progress we've made is just insane.
At HAX, we focus on physical sciences investments. That's anything that if you drop it on your foot, it hurts.
HAX is the only VC with reflow ovens and plasma cutters.
Here at HAX, our focus is really on early stage pre-seed hard tech startups. They come and co-locate with us, so we work with them directly in our space.
We have a team of 25 people here, full stack design engineering resource. In order for a startup founder to go and hire that, they would need to raise tens of millions of dollars.
Currently, the team is just the three founders, but actually it feels like we're 20 plus. And the opportunity to come to this space, get all of the support, the equipment, that's all been hugely valuable in accelerating our product development.
Whenever you get a team of people that have done this 100 times, you automatically get a whole load of experience that speeds up everything that you do.
We had a $3,000 lab prototype that was about 6 feet tall. Now we have devised it into a sleek medical device that costs around $500. And we did the entire process in less than 6 weeks.
So we have our headquarters here in Newark, and we have an incredible CapEx and OpEx investment in this space. Why do we do that? We identified that the earliest and brightest PhDs require a huge amount of help from an engineering perspective to take the science that they have to a commercial scalable entity.
What you often find is venture capital firms lack this deep technical expertise and tools that HAX brings to teams developing early stage products. And there's really not that many places around the world that can actually do this.
Working at the HAX offices, it's a gigantic value add. I have seen PhD students or researchers fail to realize that they need to turn what they've made, that science, into something that people want to buy. And that's really not a trivial process.
When designing out this space, we really tried to concentrate on every little part of the perfect lab for a physical sciences startup. So we have a mechanical lab for cutting material and doing some of the heavier engineering.
We also have our own CNC machinery.
We have a 3D printing area where we have a whole farm of 3D printers that can very quickly prototype.
We have anything from SLS to FDM and SLA printers.
We have an electronics area for testing, prototyping, and assembly of different electrical components.
And then we also have a chemical lab with benchtop hoods as well as walk-in hoods. So that really helps any of the teams that need to do wet chemistry, that are working on things like electrochemistry, to do those experiments that they need to do to de-risk their technology.
And all of the companies here have access to our global presence.
We have offices in Shenzhen, China, in Pune, India, and we have a satellite office in Tokyo. Our Shenzhen office is specifically focused on electrical engineering and supply chain sourcing. Pune has kind of emerged as a center of excellence for heavy engineering. We have a large number of engineers that will do everything from computational engineering to machining certain parts, and then they'll send them over here again for final assembly. And you can hear some of that final assembly happening right now.
It's a smorgasbord of technology development. And if there is something that isn't here, then it can be sourced pretty easily.
NJIT and Rutgers are right next door to us. We share facilities with them. The Economic Development Association for New Jersey are fantastic partners. Another great thing about being here in Newark, you have access to the Eastern Corridor for some of the best talent and some of the best venture capital funds that can continue to invest in the companies. And we are 20 minutes away on a train from our sibling program, IndieBio, based in New York.
HAX really transformed the trajectory of our company, and I think accepting HAX's investment and being a part of the community was probably the single best decision we've made in the charter of our company.
There's a huge advantage here in the ecosystem that we're building. We have the best possible cohort that you can have around you to help you as an early stage founder. We've got, for example, one founder here who previously founded a billion-dollar company. Now she was an original HAX founder who's then come back again.
So the first company I started was 2014. We joined HAX in Shenzhen. They provide enormous support and network. In addition, they just opened this new space in New York, and we literally can sign the lease, get the thing happening within 2 days. So I think it's the speed that only HAX can provide.
And we're all sitting in the same space as our founders. So there's always that hands-on support in there. Our team is always accessible. The startup journey can be lonely, but here at HAX, everyone knows that they're not going through this journey alone. We're a team, we're a family, you know?